Hello, study partners. Today we'll be discussing basics of biostatistics. So without delay, let me start a few basics. Measures of central tendency. Okay, first of all, what is the meaning of measures of central tendency? So biostatistics, by now you would have had a rough idea that we take a large population, arrange them in either ascending or descending order and study their characteristics, right? So measures of central tendency is any calculation or any work you do to get to know the center part of this ascending and descending order of the population. So how do you get to know what is the core or the center part of this arrangement of the values you have got? So you have three values for that. One is mean, second is median, and mode. Okay, mean is nothing but the average of mean is all mean has another name known as average, right? So you take any random value. Let's say you go to a classroom and you make people stand in some ascending order of their height in some fourth, fifth class or something. So I'm gonna take some random, very blunt example. Like you've arranged students in ascending order of their height, like 1, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 5. So this is their, you've arranged their, this is as per their ascending order of their height. Yes, the shortest student is 1 foot tall and the tallest student is 5 feet tall. Okay, jokes apart. So what is mean? Mean is nothing but calculating what is the average height of any student in this class, correct? So the average height of this particular class is you sum up all the values. 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5. So this comes to like around 21 feet. Divided by number of values. How many values are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7. So 21 by 7. So the average height of this class is 3 feet. Okay. So this is the basic concept of mean. So next, let me go to median. What is median? Median is any value which is the centermost value of any distribution, say ascending order or descending order, which is the center value, that is the median. So take the same example. 1, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so how many values are there here? 7 values are there. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So this is the centermost value. So median for this distribution is 3. Okay, now this was easy because you have odd number of values. So you could easily spot the center value. What if it was even? 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, 5. So what you do, you take centermost two values. See, if it is odd, you will get a center single value. If it is even, you will get two central values. So take those two center values and take average of that. What is the average of 3 and 3? Sum of both the values by number of values. So it will be 3 plus 3 divided by 2. That will be again 3. So median for odd number of values is the center value. Median for even number of values is the average of two center values. Okay. So this one thing I really wanted to stress on. Next, mode. Mode is the most repeated number. So something which is very frequent, that is mode. So this is most commonly used in bimodal distribution. So let's take the example of, let's see what is the mode of this distribution. 1, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 5. So what happens here? Which is the most commonly repeated value? It is 3. So mode of this distribution is 3. Okay. Now, this is the measures of central tendency. So why is this mean, median, mode important? Now I'll cover the basics of normal distribution in a separate video. So at present in a normal distribution, whatever you assume is whenever you take a normal distribution, sorry, whenever you take a general population, you assume that the population is distributed from center to outwards. What is the meaning of that? There is maximum number of people in this range, followed by little number of people in this range and very less here. So normal distribution says that whenever you study a population in ascending or descending order, the maximum people are concentrated towards or in and around the average, and the number of people who are present far from the average keep decreasing as you go away from the average. This is why the number of people who are around 3 feet are maximum here, but there is only one person with 1 foot and only one person with 5 feet. This generally, normal distribution is generally studied with any measurable value like mean, median, mode. So what you do, you take general population's height or hemoglobin or weight or whatever, and when you study, what happens? The number of values get accumulated around the average. So there's one thing you need to know. There is something called as which of the following values get most affected by the extreme values. So first thing you would have realized that mean is something mathematical calculation, correct? It is not something you observe like a median or a mode. What do you do in median and mode? You list all the values as per ascending or descending order, and you see for median which is the centermost value, and for mode you see which value has been repeated the most. But for mean, you don't have to arrange the values in ascending or descending order. You just sum up everything and divide by number of values. So when, if the, in this particular example itself, when you see mean, what happens if suddenly there is one person of height 20, or if suddenly, okay, let's, this is only for example purpose to make it obvious, if there is suddenly some another person of height minus 5. So mean considerably reduces if there is one person with minus 5 height in one class, or mean considerably increases a lot if there is just even one person with a height of 20. So extreme values mostly affect mean and slightly affect median, because this center value gets shifted by one, by that one extra person, and it is least, it least affects the mode. So extreme values generally affect the mean a lot, slightly affect the median, and they affect mode the least. So as we saw in this previous example, we got mean as 3 feet, median as 3 feet, and mode as also 3. So this is a normal distribution where in normal distribution, mean, median, and mode are equal or they coincide. That is nothing but the center point. So what happens when there is one extreme value? If there is one extreme value, that extreme value, if it is negative, so whatever was distributed around the center, now the center shifts, right? So this, if there is one extreme value, it becomes something like this, correct? Because of this one extreme value, or if the one extreme value is positive, it shifts like this. Because this side is generally positive, this is considered the zero and this is considered negative. So when there is one extreme positive value, the curve shifts like this, and when there is extreme negative value, the curve shifts like this. So then what I the mode is the something which has been repeated maximum number of times. So this will always be the mode. Okay, so what next, what I told, median will get shifted slightly. So median will get shifted slightly, and the maximum value that is affected will be the mean. Okay, so this particular graph which has one extreme negative value is called negative skewness, and something that has one extreme positive value is called positive skewness. So in a normal distribution where there is no skewing and where values are distributed around the center, mean is equal to median is equal to mode, correct? Next, whenever you have to write this, first think of mode, then think of median and mean. Here in negative skewing, mode remains the same, correct? Next, what happens? Next is the median. Median is slightly affected. It becomes less because of that particular negative value, and mean becomes very less. Mean becomes very less because of that negative value. So just remember, same exact opposite happens, that mode is not at all affected. It's again in the center. Next, slightly increment will be seen in median, and maximum rise will be seen for a positive skew in mean. So if you want to remember that, whenever you get confused in your exam whether what kind of symbol you have to draw between mean, median, and mode, just remember that mode never gets affected and mean gets affected maximum, and place the median in the center. Median is nothing but a center value, so it is the thing that remains in the center. I hope this helps. So next video I'll be talking about normal distribution. I'm so sorry that this video got delayed, and I'm very glad that we reached 100 subscribers and I've got so many positive comments, and I will keep working hard and making more videos for you all. So thank you so much for so much feedback, and also yay, we reached 100 subscribers. So until then, keep studying, work hard, stay positive. So this is your study partner signing off.